A very warm welcome to another session of CNEWS interview. I am Devyani Madaik, and today we have with us an eminent scholar, eminent teacher, Professor D P Agrawal. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Professor D P Agrawal is the former chairperson of Union Public Service Commission. Prior to this, he was also a member of UPSC. He's been an eminent scholar, eminent teacher, an educational administrator, and institution builder. He's also the founder director of Atal Bihari Vajpayee Indian Institute of Information Technology and Management, Gwalior. He has also been awarded Engineer of the Year Award 2006 by the Institution of Engineers. He's also been honored by the Honorary Fellowship Award in 2006 by Technical Education and Indian Society. Welcome, sir.
Thank you for coming.
Sir, to start with, I would like to ask you, in order to foster and shaping young minds, what is the major role of an educational institution, according to you?
Education is crucial for any human being's growth. Over the years, there has been change in the needs and requirements of young people, and adjustment in education delivery accordingly has been done. And I therefore believe a clear education delivery to suit present-day learner is going to empower a youth for his future.
So, what do you see challenges to the higher education, especially in a country like India?
I would say three challenges. One, that there has been a lot of expansion, which has impacted the quality of education. Number two, the expectation of the workplace from the graduates. And third, the inclusiveness about the availability of education.
All right.
All these three has to be addressed, and there has been effort in last 10 to 15 years to address each of these issues.
So what, according to you, is the direct, how is there a direct link between an education and national identity?
Education has to be built in a social milieu, and society and education has gone hand in hand. And therefore, any national agenda has to evolve through education in society. And therefore, role for each of us when planning education delivery, to ensure that the national objectives, national agenda are addressed to. And I don't see a possibility when education can be divorced from the needs of society and the nation.
So more often we hear about how difficult it is to crack a civil services examination. And there's a myth to say so that your academic record has to be very fine. What would you say to the people who have been average in their studies till undergraduation and would like to apply for the exams further?
You see, this exam has a competition. 10-11 lakh people apply. However, 6.5 lakh people appear. And vacancy being 1,000, so it's a large process of selection where rejection occur quite significantly. As I said, to appear in this exam, we don't look at the first class or second class. Opportunity for everybody is equal. What they look at is your preparedness to accept the new learning which is required to be successful in this exam. For example, one of the requirements is that you should have an aptitude. The other requirement that you should know your culture, history, geography, social science, political science. And those who can assimilate all this by self-learning, by class learning, by university learning, I'm sure will have an equal opportunity. But working hard, devotedly, single-mindedness are the three other watchword.
So does one need to have a graduation, or one need to select a particular side of field in order to appear for these examinations? Could it be from any background, irrespective of...
It permits any students of any background.
Right.
If you look at the results over the year, all kinds of students have been selected. In one of the year, the topper was who studied Telugu. Other year, he was an engineer. One year, he was a girl who did something else. So there is a scope for everybody who has actually prepared hard for this exam.
To say so, sir, nowadays we see a lot of competition, especially for the civil services examinations. So, considering a lot of competition nowadays, what would you suggest to the young minds or to the people who've applied or are giving a thought of applying for the civil services examinations? What would be your suggestion so that things that they should keep in mind in order to have an upper hand in exams?
Civil services exam actually looks at your assimilation of education and improvement in your personality as you go through educational setup. There are most of the students who are graduates who appear for civil service. However, the way the civil service selections look in a particular candidate, it requires him to read about the country, it requires them to read about development, it requires them to look at the cultural issues, it requires them to be expert in one of the subjects, and therefore an overall personality growth of a candidate is a must. Now, those who are hard workers, those who can spend time, those who can learn themselves, those who have a fixed goal in their mind, I'm sure they'll be successful.
For these to appear for exams and to prepare for these exams, people usually relocate from their area to Delhi in order to seek for coaching classes. What do you have to say about it, especially the coaching classes?
I mean, most of the people believe that I'm generally not in favor of coaching. Not that I don't appreciate the role the coaching would play, but this exam particularly rely on your own strengths. If you are very strong in terms of working very hard, you are able to comprehend, you are able to rationalize your answer. Now, these virtues you have to develop yourself. What coaching center, in my opinion, must have been providing them, available material for which they have not to dig out. And therefore, maybe some time is saved when this is available to you on a platter. Ultimately, it is for you to assimilate that material and answer that particular question in a manner where there is a logical answer. So, there is a role for clear understanding, but possibly, yes, they go to coaching where they have material available.
So, in the assimilation, as you said, in assimilation of preparing for the exam, they have this until unless a student is devoting 16 hours every day for a year. So, what would you suggest to the students as to how they should divide their time or what should be their time management?
See, time management is a must. Not all students will have similar grasps. Somebody who got a very quick understanding, quick grasps, they have demonstrated when they were students. I have come across students who have only studied 6 hours a day. I have also come across students who have studied as much as a given a chance all 24 hours. But then it depends on individual. There is no fixed prescription which would say you must study for 15 hours. I won't agree with it. It depends on individual, his own strengths. So every candidate who want to take a jump to become a civil servant, they have to judge for themselves whether what are the strengths they have and how they can exploit their strength to become successful.
So, sir, what would your message be for the young minds today?
Assess yourself. Know that you can take this challenge. It may be one time, it may be two times, but it's for you to decide how many times you want to do. Your clear understanding of a subject, your more learning, knowing your society, making yourself very clear when you are answering are some of the things you must do. So to all my young friends who want to take a chance and want to become civil servants, and we definitely require very bright young people coming to civil services because they can make a lot of difference the way the governance is done in this country, that they be very honest people, very hardworking people, and they can take positions based on clear thinking.
So you've been in this field for many years. Could you please tell us how civil services or how much it is important in a democratic country like India?
I already mentioned that the governance structure in this country has a very specific role for civil servants. All the policies which the government make, civil service have to implement. And if the people are bright and honest at the ground level in civil service, they have come up with a lot of innovation so that the delivery is very quick, delivery is focused, delivery is targeted, and the results are better. I see in future the role change will occur, but the role of policy implementation will remain with civil service. Luckily for in this country, public has lot of belief in them, and this must give lot of confidence to all those aspiring, that people respect you for something which you are going to do. You are not a politician, you are a doer, and your role is to do what people expect of you.
Thank you so much, sir, for coming here and gracing us with your presence.
Indeed, my pleasure that I am in here.
This is Devyani Madaik signing off from this session of CNEWS. Thank you.